the Alex Trebek stage at Sony Pictures Studios, this is Jeopardy! Today's contestants are an undergrad student, an EMT, from New Providence, New Jersey, Guhan Venkatesan. An ophthalmologist from Minneapolis, Minnesota, Carolyn Minkus. And our returning champion, a PhD student from New Haven, Connecticut, Matt Amodio, whose 26-day cash winnings total $929,401. And now, here is the host of Jeopardy, Mayim Bialik.
Thank you, Johnny Gilbert. Welcome to Jeopardy. As you just heard Johnny announce, Matt Amodio has now won 26 games. It is an incredibly exciting time to be here. Welcome to Caroline and to Guhan. Let's play Jeopardy with these categories. Literary terms. Sports venue nicknames. World War II Navajo Code Talkers Dictionary. Money idioms. And peak, my interest. Matt?
Literary 1000.
The ancient door groaned when I opened it makes use of this device giving human attributes to non-human things. Guhan.
What is personification?
Yes.
Sports venue nicknames for 400.
The Gonzaga University Bulldogs basketball teams play at McCarthy Athletic Center, nicknamed this canine shelter. Guhan.
What is the dog pound?
No. Caroline.
What is the dog house?
No. What is the kennel? Guhan, your pick.
Peak 200.
See the sun earlier than most hiking the Cadillac Mountain North Ridge Trail in this state's Acadia National Park. Guhan.
What is Maine?
That's right.
Money idioms 200.
Dropping one of these on another person means you're informing on his criminal activities. Caroline.
What is a dime?
Yes.
Money idioms 4.
This rhyming term refers to the output of a counterfeiter. Matt.
What's?
No.
Bony money.
Caroline.
What is funny money?
Yes, that's correct.
Money 600.
Something that has no value is said to be not worth a plugged this. Matt.
What's nickel?
Yes, and that puts you on the plus side.
Peak 1000.
This alpine peak inspired Shelley to write a 5-part poem. Guhan.
What is a Matterhorn?
No. Matt.
What's Mont Blanc?
That's correct.
My interest 1000.
Rest a spell in your cave and tell us of your love for this pastime of exploring them. Matt.
What's spelunking?
Yes.
World War II 1000.
These opposite military movements, toward and away from battle, were Nase and Jidin Neschan. Matt.
What's retreat and charge?
No. Guhan.
What is advance and retreat?
Yes, and that puts you in the positive.
Sports venue nicknames for 800, please.
The centerpiece of the 2008 Olympics, the national stadium seen here, has this avian nickname. Matt.
What's bird's nest?
That's right.
Literary 800.
Juliet's good night is followed by these 5 words that include an oxymoron. Matt.
What's parting is such sweet sorrow?
Yes.
World War II 800.
A fighter plane was Dahi Tihi, one of these hovering avians. Caroline.
What is a hummingbird?
Correct.
World War II 600.
This enemy was Bays B. Chahi, or Iron Hat. Matt.
What's Germany?
That's right.
Peak 800.
An extinct volcano, Mount Elbrus, in the Caucasus Mountains, is located in this country. Guhan.
What is Russia?
Yes.
Sportsman nicknames for 1,000, please.
Nicknamed the Loud House, the Carrier Dome is the stadium of this university in New York State. What is Syracuse University? We've got a very interesting and tight game here. We'll be back for more right after this. Welcome back to Jeopardy. Let's get to know our contestants. Guhan Venkatesan, an undergrad student and EMT from New Providence, New Jersey. You had a fire drill during your Jeopardy audition?
Yeah, so my audition took place because it was spring semester of my sophomore year. It took place in my apartment on campus. And during the interview section of the Zoom audition, I heard the fire alarm. I was like, wait a minute, that's mine. So I quickly texted the producer, I have a fire drill, I'll be right back. Closed my laptop, walked outside in the middle of Boston in the middle of March, and then waited until the fire drill was clear, came back in, and actually got to finish my interview.
Sounds like it was a pretty hot interview.
You could say that.
Caroline Minkus, an ophthalmologist from Minneapolis, Minnesota. You do many amazing things. You've climbed Kilimanjaro, you've climbed around Mont Blanc, you've run 3 marathons, but I'm most interested in the fact that you created a March Madness tournament for your dog.
Yes, so our dog's name is Mozzie, and when we weren't sure if March Madness would happen, my little brother suggested we run Mozzie Madness. So we created a single elimination bracket, and he chooses between 2 toys at a time until we reach a winner.
That's amazing. And let's turn to our returning champion, Matt Amodio, PhD student from New Haven, Connecticut. Now, many people play an instrument for years so that they can perfect it. You've chosen the opposite approach.
Yeah, a lot of very accomplished musicians come on the show and talk about their incredible talent, but I wanted to give a voice to people like me who has played guitar for over a decade now, and still all I can do is play the same 2 Red Hot Chili Peppers songs over and over and over again.
I think that's all you need. Let's get back to the game. Guhan, you pick.
My interest for 600.
From words meaning earth and hide, it's the pastime involving searching for hidden goods using GPS. Guhan.
What is geocaching?
Correct.
Literary terms for 600.
A sheet of thin metal shares its name with this, a character who contrasts with the hero or heroine. Matt.
What's foil?
That's right.
Money, idioms, 8.
Makes sense. These 2 words begin the idiom that ends pound foolish. Caroline.
What is pennywise?
Yes.
Money idioms 1,000.
Cash that you are eager to spend is figuratively said to do this to your clothes. Guhan.
What is burn a hole in your pocket?
Yes.
My interest for 800, please.
A philumenist likes to collect these books. The reading, though minimal, can lead to enlightenment. Matt.
Well, it's matchbooks.
Correct.
Peak 6.
Mount Kanchenjunga, the world's 3rd tallest peak, resides in this range. Matt.
What's Himalayas?
Yes.
Literary 4.
And then a million people started screaming at me at once is an example of this exaggeration for effect. Matt.
What's hyperbole?
Correct.
Peak 400.
Seen here, New Zealand's Mount Aurukee is fittingly translated as cloud piercer from this language. Caroline.
What is Maori?
That's right.
Literary 200.
Sign that kid up. He runs like a thoroughbred. Is one of these comparative figures of speech. Guhan.
What's a simile?
Yes.
Sports venue nicknames for 600.
There's a daily double. Matt is in the lead at 5,800. You have 3,400. What would you like to wager?
1,500.
All right. Here is your clue. Home to an NHL team, the SAP Center in this California city is nicknamed the Shark Tank.
What is San Jose?
That is correct. Very nice. That brings you to 4,900. Pick again.
Navajo code talkers for 400, please.
These weapons were nimasi, meaning potatoes. Caroline.
What are mines?
No. Matt.
What's grenades?
Yes.
My interest for?
Vectorists crave these small round items like old ones from the New York City Transit Authority. Guhan.
What are tokens? Subway tokens.
Yes, subway tokens.
My interest 200.
A mycophile is a culinary hobbyist on the hunt for wild these. Guhan.
What are mushrooms?
That's correct.
Code talkers for 200.
This armored fighting vehicle was Che Dagahi, a tortoise. Caroline.
What is a tank?
Yes. And the last clue? The stadium of this Gainesville school is officially Ben Hill Griffin Stadium, but it's nicknamed the Swamp. Matt.
What's Florida?
Correct. The University of Florida. That brings you to 6,400. Guhan has 5,500. Caroline, you have 2,000. And we're going to play Double Jeopardy right after this. Welcome back. It's time for Double Jeopardy. Caroline, you are going to pick first from one of these categories. Historic women. Superlatives. Welcome to ComicCon. Revival. Role players. And definitions. Caroline.
Definitions 400, please.
It's a four-letter synonym for adroit or skillful. Guhan.
What is deft?
Yes.
Historic women for 1200.
After briefly dancing in Paris as Lady MacLeod, she soon changed her name to a Malay one, meaning Eye of the Dawn. Guhan.
Who is Mata Hari?
That's right.
Historic women for 800.
In 1993, Ellen Ochoa became the first Latina launched into space aboard this shuttle, also a 2017 Star Trek series. Matt.
What's Discovery?
Yes.
Historic women, 16.
In 1969, Shirley Chisholm attacked the Vietnam War in the first floor speech of her 14-year run as a representative of this state. Guhan.
What's Texas?
No. Matt.
What's New York?
Correct.
Historic women, 2000.
A programming language is named after this daughter of Lord Byron, who is called the world's first computer programmer. Guhan.
Who is Ada Lovelace?
That's right.
Revival for 400.
Nationality name for the literary revival that included writers like Yeats and O'Casey. Matt.
What's Irish?
Correct.
Comet 16.
In 1997, the world caught sight of this comet named for two amateur astronomers. Caroline.
What is Hale-Bopp?
Yes.
Comet for 12.
The four visible parts of a comet are the nucleus, coma, ion tail, and this tail that sounds like a bottle of Pledge will get rid of it. Caroline.
What is a smudge tail?
No. What is dust? Caroline, pick again.
Definitions for 8, please.
Yield to another and you're showing this courteous regard. Matt.
What's deferential?
Yes.
Comet 2000.
The source of many observable short-period comets is the belt beyond Neptune, named for this Dutch-American astronomer. Guhan.
Who is Kuiper?
That's right.
Superlatives for 400.
Since 1985, People magazine has been pointing out this person, including Sean Connery and Michael B. Jordan. Caroline.
Who is sexiest man of
yes,
the year?
Correct.
Superlatives for 8.
It's a daily double. How much of your 2,800 would you like to wager?
I'd like to make it a true daily double.
True daily double. All right, here's your clue. Before woman alive, this word is often applied to multiple Olympic champion Elaine Thompson-Herah of Jamaica.
Who is fastest?
Yes, very nice. Brings you up to 5,600.
Superlatives for 12, please.
Seen but not heard here for safety reasons, Man of War vied for and sometimes achieved this distinction. Matt.
What's loudest?
Loudest band, 139 decibels.
Comet 8.
An unusual object known as 288P has a tail, so it's classed as a comet, but it's basically a binary this, also called a minor planet. Matt.
What's dwarf?
No. Caroline.
What's star?
No. What is an asteroid? Matt, pick again.
Revival 16.
There's a daily double. You are at 10,400 and Guhan is gaining at 9,500.
10,400.
Okay, 10,400 it is. Here's your clue. Search Etsy for the revival of this 19th century movement of William Morris that itself looked back to the fine work of medieval times.
What's arts and crafts?
That is correct. Well done. Brings you up to 20,800.
Superlatives 2,000.
Motivational author Zig Ziglar reminded us to expect the best, followed by these four words. Caroline.
What is prepare for the worst?
Yes.
Superlative 16.
While attending Beverly Hills High, When Harry Met Sally screenwriter Nora Ephron was dubbed this four-word future winner. Guhan.
What is greatest of all time?
No. Caroline.
What is most likely to succeed?
That's correct. Very
nice. Definitions 1200, please.
The Joint Chiefs of Staff coined this acronym for a state of alertness in 1959. Matt.
What's DEFCON?
Yes.
Revival 2000?
Baroque revival architecture is typified by London's criminal courts building called the Old This. It was new in 1907. Guhan.
What is Bailey?
That's correct.
historic women for 400.
This first lady's last words in 1818, "Do not grieve, my friend, my dearest friend. I am ready to go. And John, it will not be long." Matt.
What's Abigail Adams?
Yes.
Definitions 2000.
Latin for window partly gives us this word that means to throw someone out of a window. Guhan.
What is defenestrate?
Correct.
Role players for 2000.
Sulu in recent Star Trek films and Kumar's pal Harold Lee. Guhan.
Who is Cal Penn?
No. Who is John Cho? Guhan, your pick.
Role player 1600.
Justice in 1993's Poetic Justice and Charlene Dupre on the TV show Different Strokes. Matt.
What's Janet Jackson?
Yes.
Definition 16.
Excess of spending over revenue or the margin by which a team trails an opponent. Guhan.
What is deficit?
That's correct.
Role players for 12.
Gabrielle Solis on Desperate Housewives and Beatriz Mendoza on Grand Hotel. Matt.
What's Longoria?
That's correct, Eva Longoria.
Revival 12.
1765's Relics of Ancient English Poetry was part of a revival of this type of folk poem, like the one of Constant Susanna. What is a ballad? Don't You Cry For Me. Matt, pick again.
Role players 8.
Machete and what? You Need More? Tyrannosaurus, Death and Muerte. Matt.
What's Trejo?
Correct, Danny Trejo.
Revival 8.
19th century news, like the discovery of the Rosetta Stone, inspired the style called this revival. Matt.
What's Egyptian?
Yes.
Role players 4, please.
Jane Foster and Padme Amidala in two very, very different universes. Caroline.
Who's Portman?
Yes, Natalie Portman. And the last clue? Here's a 1986 shot of this regular visitor that got its name in 1759. Caroline.
What is Halley's Comet?
That is correct. It's time for Final Jeopardy, and here's the category. Food and drink in the Bible. Make your wagers. We'll be back right after this.
We'll be back with Final Jeopardy right after this.
Welcome back. It is time for Final Jeopardy. The category is food and drink in the Bible. Here's your clue. In the King James Version, these creatures are a plague in Exodus 10, but deemed okay to eat in Leviticus 11. You have 30 seconds. Good luck. All right, let's start with you, Caroline Minkus. You have 9,200. What did you come up with? What are locusts? That is correct. The eighth plague on Egypt in the New Testament, John the Baptist eats locusts with wild honey. What did you wager? Wow, $8,000. That's gonna bring you all the way up to 17,200. Let's go over to Guhan Venkatesan. Did you come up with locusts? You did, and how much did you wager? Wow, that is a big wager. This brings you to 22,993. It's all gonna come down to Matt Amodio. Did you get locusts? No, looks like you thought about it, but went with what are frogs? What's that gonna cost you? $1,000, that leaves you with 25,800 and a 27-day total of 955,201. You are a reigning Jeopardy champion. Congratulations. Thank you all for playing. Thank you, and we will see you tomorrow.
Promotional consideration provided by Consumer Cellular.